वेलकम टू 2 मिनट क्लासेस. द टॉपिक इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फॉर लूप. ओके, सो वी विल सी एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फाइंडिंग फैक्टोरियल ऑफ अ नंबर. ओके, वी आर अवेयर दैट फैक्टोरियल ऑफ अ नंबर एन इज 1 × 2 × 3 टिल एन. सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड फैक्टोरियल ऑफ 5, सो इट विल बी द आंसर लाइक द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ 1 × 2 × 3 × 4 × 5, दैट इज इक्वल टू 120. ओके, सो ओवर हियर वी कैन सी दैट वी आर गोइंग टू रिपीट द प्रोसेस ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन. And every time we are going to multiply the previous answer with a incremented value. So I will multiply 1 with 2, then its answer will be multiplied with 3, then its answer will be multiplied with 4, then the answer which I will obtain will be multiplied by 5. Then I will get my final answer. Okay? So in order to store the previously calculated product, we are going to initialize a variable fact. Okay, so fact is a variable. This is an example to find factorial of 5. So fact equal to 1. We are going to initialize it with 1, because if you initialize it with 0, it is going to convert like 0 into 1 is going to be 0, then 0, then 0, then ultimately answer will become 0. Okay, so we are going to initialize fact with 1. Then I have applied a for loop. Again, I have written it in the same way for I in range. In range, I will think about, okay, what should be the start and end value. Step size is 1, because we are incrementing the numbers by like 1 by 1. The starting value should be 1, because we are beginning the multiplication from 1. And the ending value should be 1 greater than the number whose factorial we want to find. I want to find factorial 5. If I would have written 5 over here, this loop will go from 1, 2, 3, 4 only. I want it to go from 1 till 5, so I have written 1 more than 5, that is 6. Now the statement I have written in the loop is fact is equal to fact into I. So what fact is going to do? It is going to store all the products of previous, like all the answers of previous products. Then after the loop, okay, so my loop has completed. After this, I am printing the factorial of the number is fact. You don't write print statement in this loop. You are going to write print statement outside the loop. Okay, let us see how this example works. Okay, so it will begin from initializing the value of fact to 1 and initializing I to 1. It will start from 1. Then it will do fact into I. The value of fact is 1. 1 into 1 is 1. So the value of factorial will become 1. Okay, so it will be same. After this, I will become 2. Then it will again do fact into I. The value of fact is 1. The value of I is 2. So 1 into 2, fact will become 2. And the value of I will become 3. Then again it will execute the value, like it will multiply fact into I, 2 into 3, that is 6, and it will increase the value of I to 4. Then again it will repeat 4 into 6 is 24, and the value of I will become 5. After this it will multiply 24 into 5, it will become 120, and the value of I will become 6. As soon as value of I reaches 6, this thing will stop. Okay, so it will come out of the loop. The value, the final value of factorial will be 120, and it will print the factorial is 120. Okay, suppose I want to find out factorial of any number user entered by user. In that case, what I will do, I will input a number, int input. Okay, you can write enter a number over here. And after this, instead of 6, I will write n plus 1. So suppose I have entered the number as 10. The loop will execute from 1 to 11. That means 11 minus 1, it will execute from 1 to 10. Okay. So this is how you can find factorial of any number entered by user.